Hello my fellow gearheads and especially lovers of anything Dungeons and Dragons related. This thing launched yesterday and today I finally found my way to the shop. So I can't wait to unbox all of these and review them as I go. So let's start with the first one without any further ado. The packaging is the standard paper box, and if I open the very first one, Oh yes, this is one of the ones that I was really looking forward to get, and I probably need at least a second one over here. So here you have the overview of all the 12 figures, instructions how to assemble them in case you do not know or can't figure it out from the photo. And here we have the Mind Flayer with the Brain Eater. So this is really cool head sculpt. And this is gonna be fun because as far as I understand, yes, you can put it on top of a minifigure's head if you remove the hair. So this is gonna be really fun. And honestly, making a Brain Eater as a Lego element is super cool. And you can see as well over here that there are some stone tiles at the bottom of the tile. Here you can see the Mind Flayer in its full glory with printed sleeves, the back of the robe and the skirt of it, and the same goes for the front. And this is how it looks if you remove the head. So yeah, really nice detail, all shiny. And here you have Mind Flayer with its D&D counterparts, the Mind Flayer Telepath Shuluth and the Mind Flayer Lich. The height of him is not that far off in terms of the scale, but you can see how much chunkier the Lego minifigures in general are compared to the slender figures of the Mind Flayers. As the second figure, we do have this is cool. There's probably a cape, rat, and some other things in here. This one is the famous vampire Strahd von Zarovich, which is the main villain in the Castle Ravenloft campaign and in many other board and computer games that are based on the Forgotten Realms lore. And he gets nice double-sided head, one with a smirk and one with the vampire teeth out. And he as well gets a long wig, red sword, and a goblet or a wine glass. So there you have him. I don't have, unfortunately, any vampire minifigures of Strahd von Zarovich that would, you know, give you the idea how they look. The ones that I have are unpainted, so I'm not gonna bother you with this. The third figure we have is, it's the Halfling Druid, which comes with a super cool headpiece, the robe cowl with the antlers, and yeah, he looks really good, at least in my opinion. And he gets a bird as a companion, and he as well gets female and male head. That's cool. Yeah, and you can just build the staff with the leaves and the flower at the top. That's really nice and very colorful as well. Come in. Oh, Oh, I forgot the cape, of course. And you get a double-sided one, so it's brown from one side and green on the other side. I think I'm gonna keep the green on the outside because that's how I like it. And let's try the female head on for now. Yep, very, very cute. And here you have the druid with the other two druids that I have over here. Yeah, one of them is elf, the other one is a human, but this is how a halfling spellcaster figure should be tall. So you can see that this one in LEGO format is enormous compared to the halfling in the D&D setting. The next one up is the Lady of Pain, which has probably the coolest headpiece, well, one of the coolest definitely, that we get over here. And this is her orange skirt and torso with a nice print, very reminiscent of the emblem that the Mind Flayer has. The cape needed to be folded to fit over here, and the head of the figure doesn't have any face, but at least I can show you what I meant by the brain eater, so you can cover the head of the minifigure almost completely with the brain eater, which is super hilarious. And yeah, look at her. And then we just need to build whatever she is holding over here. Oh, this is a print. Very nice. Small but very detailed. That's cool. And you get two of these, I believe. And then this transparent part. So she levitates off the ground, wielding this cube. Let me know in the comments if you actually know what is the name of this cube. And the cool thing is you get an extra one. And look at the head. This looks great. This is just pure greatness. And of course I don't have any minifigure that I could show you, or the miniature that I could show you that would be from the D&D lore. So who is next? There we go. This is the warlock. Again, you get two heads for male and female version. Shoulder pads, you get an extra one over here. So this is, as far as I know, the only figure that has the classic yellow head, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, looks about right. And then you can add the beautiful eye with the print on top of the stuff. You get a spare dagger as well. So this is a GIF warlock, and the only warlock I have is this guy with a nice purple spell effect as well. Again, you can see how big the LEGO figure is compared to this one, but it shouldn't stop you from using them in your D&D campaigns because they still can fit a 5x5 feet square. I believe it's a figure number 6 right now, and this time it's the dwarf, I believe. Yeah, short legs again. Faces for both male and female. So this time around, let's do a female. I forgot this, the furry cape. And here we have the hair, the torch, ta-da, and a double-sided axe. And if I'm not mistaken, this is a new mold. So there you have her, and afterwards him in their full glory. So here you have the dwarf barbarian together with the battle rager and Brunor battlehammer, the D&D counterparts that I painted a few years ago. Number 7. Here we have one of the very well-known villains, which is Tasha, the Witch Queen. She's as well known from other things like Magic the Gathering. And as well, she gave her name to a book, which is called Tasha's Cauldron of Everything. And this is pretty much her cauldron. And this is her spellbook. There you go, Tasha, and she's definitely having fun, as you can see. Yeah, that's a cool figure. With, again, nice prints all around and on the book and inside the book. Probably put this upside down, but yeah, very cool. And the elf part is over here. So you again get a female and a male heads. And saber or rapier. Jeez. Come on. Oof. And oh yeah, that's a cool face singing. And obviously each bard, or every bard, needs a musical instrument. So here you get a nice printed lute. There we go. An extra rapier or saber. And the female head. This is not exactly a bard, but an elven adventurer. And you can see again how they scale together and how much smaller and how much bigger the Lego one is. And we're getting slowly closer to the end. And yeah, this is definitely one I'm as well gonna get multiples of. At least the second one would be nice, because this is the Dragonborn Paladin. You can have him just in the robe, or you can give him this beautiful coat of armor. And we know this mold of the head, because this originally came out with the video figures, if you still remember what that product line was. And you can build a nice mace with nice and glittery head, and you can afterwards add the tassel to the bottom and give him this beautiful printed shield. Oh, that's great. Absolutely fantastic. And this is how this Dragonborn Paladin compares against the D&D Dragonborn Warriors. I think this is supposed to represent the Dragonborn of Bahamut due to the emblem printed on the shield, but yes, absolutely great looking figure. And the next one is the Arakocra Ranger. For those who have seen the D&D movie, you know that Arakocras have and serve quite a significant role in that movie. And this looks great. This is very cute. And it almost looks like a Chima figure. And you get a nice little doggy, which is adorable. So yeah. There you have it. Oh, sorry, I forgot the bow and arrow, which just fell out of the box and I couldn't, oh, I didn't notice them over the camera. And right now I can't put them in his hand. Yeah, there we go. It's a very tight fit, but there we go. There you have the full figure with the pet. And only two figures left. So which one are you? Oh yeah, that's the Tiefling, which looks as well great, at least on the box. And of course, forgot to put the tail. And then, should we do a female or a male? I'm gonna do a female this time. Oh, angry. Yeah. So each of the heads gets two expression. I really do like this spell effect. And is this supposed to be a pseudo dragon? Probably. Yes, as a familiar. Okay, that looks great. So yeah, a really cool version of the Tiefling Sorcerer. Again, I don't have too many Tieflings that I could show you that would fit this type of character, but I'm super happy for the tiny red dragon. And then we know who is going to be hiding in here, because this is the evil lich himself, Shaz-Tam. And he's one of the villains as well, a necromancer, and you can see his exposed ribcage over here. He has a nice red skull with the very classic Lego print, and as well a flame spell effect in his other hand. Come on, and I forgot, of course, to put the cape. Oh, okay, so it's two capes. So the first one goes, I hope, this way. There you have him, all evil. Nice, looking really good over here. And here you have him with his friends, if you will, the Nanamat Ancient Lich, the Skull Lord, and the Deathlock. And this is as well, just for the fun of it, the Demi-Lich, which is simply a flying skull that can cast spells. Here you have the full series spinning around, so you can take a closer look at all of the figures and how do they scale next to each other, as well with the leftover parts and additional heads. And I am pretty happy with this one. Probably not as happy as with the space figures, which I absolutely adore, every single one of them, and some of them I have way too many. But the ones that I was looking for definitely didn't disappoint. The Mind Flayer with the Brain Eater is amazing. The Dragonborn Paladin looks great. The one that I probably didn't have any high expectations for is the Lady of Pain. And as well, things like the Tiefling Sorcerer really grow on me, as well as the Druid. The rest, well, you know, I could probably easily survive this series without the Elf Bard and the Dwarf Barbarian, but the rest is looking really good. So yeah, this is it from my side. Which one is your favorite? Let me know down in the comments section. And if you are new over here, don't forget to subscribe. That way you do not miss out any of my future content. Until next time, everybody, stay safe, take care, bye-bye, and good luck when playing D&D.